My name is Jason Gallant, and I'm an assistant professor of zoology at Michigan State. My lab is basically interested in the genetic basis of behaviors and particularly animal phenotypes that are related to communication. So we primarily study electric fish, but we also work on butterflies a little bit. Our two main research questions with the electric fish are, where does the electric organ come from as a tissue in evolution? And we're also interested in, when you have an electric organ, how does it diversify through evolution and lead to communicative differences between different species of electric organs? This one's discharging so fast and so regularly. So we just recently published a paper in Science on the evolution of electric organs. So electric fish have evolved 6 times independently through the history of vertebrates. And so in each case, the fish have taken skeletal muscle and made electric organ out of it. This is something that puzzled Charles Darwin. You know, when he wrote Origin of Species, he devoted a whole chapter to difficulties with this theory and considered electric fish first and foremost. So it's been a kind of a standing mystery as to how fish have done this and how they've done it so many times. So we've been looking at gene expression information across many lineages of electric fish, which has involved basically taking RNA out of their electric organs, sequencing it, and then putting all those tiny pieces back together. That's where the HPCC comes in. So we've been basically utilizing the service really heavily to assemble these transcriptome data sets and then get a better sense of which genes are expressed and how many and their relative contributions to building the electric organ. And that's been highly enabled by a lot of the resources at the HPCC. HPCC's been a critical tool in our research program. It's one of the best high-performance computing systems that I've used. I've used several from the National Science Foundation, Boston University, Cornell University. I think that MSU's had a long history of developing these tools with the users in mind, and I think it really shows. It's incredibly easy to use, logically laid out. My laboratory has a number of undergraduates working right now, and they're using it with great success. So it's been nothing but positive.